It's AumSum time!
What is insomnia?
An indoor video game.
Nah. Insomnia is a sleep disorder in which individuals find it difficult to fall asleep or stay asleep at night.
Oh.
Now, let's see some of the causes of insomnia. Firstly, disruption of our circadian rhythm. Circadian rhythm is our body's internal clock, which regulates our sleep-wake cycle.
Ah.
However, rotating job shifts or traveling through multiple time zones can disrupt our circadian rhythm, thus causing insomnia. Secondly, restless leg syndrome. It is a condition in which we feel unpleasant sensations in our legs and an irresistible urge to move them. This can also keep us from falling asleep. Thirdly, sleep apnea. It is a disorder in which breathing is repeatedly interrupted during sleep. This can occur when tissues in the back of our throat collapse, blocking the breathing passage, or when brain doesn't send proper signals to muscles that control breathing. Both of these issues can disturb our sleep, thus causing insomnia. What is sleep paralysis?
No idea.
Sleep paralysis is a condition in which we are conscious but temporarily unable to move or speak. It can usually occur when we suddenly wake up during REM sleep.
Huh? What is REM sleep?
Basically, there are four stages of sleep. One of them is rapid eye movement sleep. That is, REM sleep. In this stage, we dream. Researchers suggest that when we enter REM sleep, two chemicals, glycine and GABA, switch off the activity of cells in the brain that allow our muscles to move.
Oh no, this is so bad.
No. It is actually beneficial because paralyzed muscles prevent us from enacting our dreams in reality and getting hurt. However, sometimes we suddenly wake up during REM sleep. But if glycine and GABA are still active, we are temporarily unable to move, even though we are conscious. This is called sleep paralysis. Which is the best sleeping position?
Mine!
Alright, let's see. Sleeping on our back allows our spine to rest in a neutral position, preventing neck and back pain. Also, as the face is not pressed against the pillow, it avoids over-wrinkling. However, this position is prone to more snoring. Sleeping on our stomach prevents snoring but makes it difficult to maintain a neutral spine position. It puts pressure on our joints and muscles, leading to numbness, neck and back pain, etc. Sleeping on our side keeps the spine elongated and prevents neck and back pain. Sleeping especially on the left side decreases acid reflux, improves blood circulation, digestion, etc. However, side sleeping presses our face against the pillow and increases the chances of wrinkling. Some people even curl up tightly while sleeping on one side. This restricts breathing. Now, since all positions have advantages and disadvantages, there is no best position. But if sleeping in a specific position is causing problems, you can switch to other positions for better results. Why do we sleepwalk? Because burger joints offer 80% discount at night. Sleepwalking or somnambulism is a disorder which causes people to walk around while they're asleep. Occasionally, they may even go to the bathroom or drive a car. But what exactly is going on over here? While sleeping, our brain goes through various stages of sleep. However, sometimes, when we are in deep, non-REM stage of sleep, our brain skips the active brain, REM stage, and directly goes to being awake. Hence, we enter a state where our brain is just awake enough to perform physical activities, but it is still asleep enough to not have any conscious awareness, causing us to be in a sort of mixed state of sleep and wakefulness, thus causing us to sleepwalk. It is observed that sleepwalking is more common in children. However, factors like stress, sleep deprivation, sedative drugs, sleep apnea, etc. may lead to sleepwalking in adults.